inspired but not yet. Good wishes for a joyous Navratri and Durga Puja to you all. With a plenty of peace and prosperity, may the blessing of Goddess Durga shine on you and all your prayers be granted on this special occasion. Before starting the session, I request Director Sir to offer a floral welcome to Navratri. Anjali ma'am today in the campus. Ma'am is an educator with a vision for fundamental change in the educational system. She is the Vice President of the Integral Education Society New Delhi and Managing Trustee of the Merlot Institute of Research. This society is running an elementary and secondary education schools by the name of St. M.R. Jaipuria School, which has been ranked among the 10 schools in India. It also runs 4 business schools for postgraduate studies. As a trustee of Mothers Institute of Research, she studies Sri Aurobindo's and the Mother's intellectual work, integral yoga, and educational reforms. She also seeks to integrate matter and spirit within herself, bringing together in her house about 30 other aspirants to study the integral yoga of Sri Aurobindo and the Mother, the Vedas, the Upanishads, and the Bhagavad Gita. Shakti is a Sanskrit word and the meaning is to be able, meaning power and empowerment, is the ancient cosmic energy and represent the dynamic forces that are thought to move through the entire universe in Hinduism. You aim at a result and your efforts serve one that is a different or contrary. It is Shakti that has gone forth and entered into the people. The first and the ultimate principle of the universe is feminine power, which is Shakti, whose personified from is beauty and whose essential nature is consciousness and bliss. To further enlighten us on this beautiful concept on the very first day of Navratri, now invite Anjali ma'am to share her views and explain the role of Shakti in our life.
Good afternoon. So, how many of you are really interested in this topic? Don't have to do it by force. You're really interested?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you want to know about Shakti? Aap bataiye. Aap Shakti ke baare mein kya janna chahte hain? Everything. Acha, mere ko Shakti ke baare mein kaun batayega? Kya jante hain hum Shakti ke baare mein? Koi to bataye. हम सब इंडियंस हैं, सिंस चाइल्डहुड वी हर्ड अबाउट शक्ति, वी वर्शिप हर इन द नवरात्र. हु इज शी?
गॉडेस दुर्गा.
गॉडेस दुर्गा. एंड देयर इज गॉडेस दुर्गा. एंड द पिक्चर था इनसाइड अस. यस, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. शी इज इनसाइड अस एंड शी इज एनीवेयर एल्स बिसाइड्स इनसाइड अस. Everywhere. And we can experience her? When can we experience her? All the time. Yeah? Do we need more chairs in the back? We can get more chairs. Satinder, can we organize some more chairs? They can come in the front also. When you experience her? Motivated. Anything else that we feel when yes?
It is in the form of energy. We feel energized.
Very nice. We feel motivated. We feel energized. Very, very nice. So, this world has produced quite a few sciences, right? Actually, I've been given a few questions by Rajivji. So, I would like to start on the topic right away. Who was it who was going to work? Can I just put the questions to myself? I can just answer them. So we have a few questions here. The questions are, will I just keep questioning myself and answering? Is that alright with you all? The first question is, who is Shakti? Okay, so we have already discussed it kind of, that Shakti is an energy, a force, right? Now, everything that is being discovered as a science is more understandable to us, right? What is science? When is a study called a science? There must be children or students who study science. When is a study called a science? Ye to science hai. Evidence. Repeated experiments which lead to the same result, and so we say this is verifiable through repeated experiments, so it is a science. Which are the sciences that have been discovered or named in the world? Which are the sciences you studied in school? Physics, chemistry, and
biology.
Okay. Physics is the science of? Physics is the science of matter, and biology is the science of life, and psychology is the science of mind. So we are basically made up of three parts which are very evident to people: matter, our body, and then life, our emotions, our life force, and our mind, right? And all the three have been found scientifically, and they can be studied scientifically through physics, chemistry, and biology. But there is one more science which the West didn't know, which was discovered by India. What is that science?
Mythology
is not a science. Mythology is stories. What is that science?
Spiritual.
Yes, but what is that science called?
Meditation
is part of that science. What is that science
called?
Beg your pardon? Yes, spirituality comes as a part of that science. It's the science of yoga. Now yoga, what is yoga? Can anybody tell me what is yoga? Is it pranayam, doing this makar asana or that asana? Is that yoga?
Balance of body and mind.
What is yoga basically? What word does it come from? Yoga.
Yud.
Yes. And what does yud mean? To join. To join. To unite. Okay. Yug. The English word also has the same root. The English word yoke has the same root. Yoke the horses to the chariots. So unite the horses to the chariots. And yoga comes from that word. It means to unite. When we use the instruments of our body to unite with the divine, we call it karma yoga. When we use the instrument of our mind to unite with the divine, with God, we call it dhyan yoga. And when we use the instrument of our emotion to join with God, it is bhakti yoga. Hai na? All this is part of the science of yoga, which was developed by India, by our ancients, by our seers. And Shakti is the discovery by our scientists, by our seers, in this science. Shakti is a force. And what does this Shakti do? What does this yoga do? What does the science of yoga do most importantly? The science of yoga studies God, studies us, studies the cosmos, studies the relationship between all of them, right? And because of this science, we are able to understand how God is, where is God. He cannot be put into just a picture. Of course, he's in the picture. But he cannot be just in the frame. Can he be? He must be more omnipresent than that. So, science of yoga tells us how we can join with God. Where is God? And Shakti is basically a concept of this science. When we talk of Shakti, what comes to our mind first of all, is force, energy, and power, right? Does any other word come to you when you think of Shakti? All these three words are used in our physical sciences: force, energy, and power. But does any other word come to our mind which is different from them and which actually explains what Shakti is? Beg your pardon? Adi Shakti is Shakti only, na? So let us first just keep, I've made these slides so we can recapitulate every thought that we've said and we move ahead. So the Indian science of yoga has taught us how to awaken to the presence of the divine, how to connect with the divine, unite with the divine, such that we can become instruments of the divine. And Shakti is basically a concept of this yogic science. The fourth word that really explains Shakti, which is the most important word to explain and to understand Shakti, is potency. Can anybody here explain to me what is potency? Yes? Do we have a mic? Floating mic? Yeah, please.
Potency can probably be linked with potentiality.
Yes.
A seed, for example.
Very nice. You just hit the nail on the head. Yes.
I've been a student of philosophy and I've studied yoga.
Yes.
And
yes.
There's a term in India.
Yeah.
So I very well. So
very good. The fourth and most important word to really understand Shakti is potency. And as man has nicely explained to us, potency is that which seems quiet, which seems quiescent, but which has the potential to become. Right? And Shakti is that potency lying hidden, latent, quiet, sleeping within all of us. Somebody here said Shakti is within us. Right? Shakti is within us, hidden, quiet, seeming to be asleep, but with all the potentiality latent and asleep within us. This is Shakti. And as ma'am has given the example, a seed has potential. Potential to become a large tree. Can someone else give me some examples of potential? What are the potentials? Do we have? Somebody may be having the potential to be able to write poetry. Beautiful poetry. But it is hidden. Somebody has the potential to be able to do beautiful art. One of us may have the potential to be a director in a movie. But our parents have told us, no. Go to Jaipuria Institute of Management, Noida, learn some business and go and do a job. So that potentiality lies hidden within, not at all intact. That is potency, that which has the capacity to become, but which is lying latent within us. And that is Shakti.
The outer manifestation of potency man we call creativity.
Yeah, but yes. Creativity, even Shakti, with the help of Shakti, that sleeping potential can come out and create. It is Shakti which creates. Absolutely right, sir. So, what is the inherent potentiality of Shakti? Shakti has inherently the potential to manifest the conscious will of God Himself. Right? Now, who is God here? What is the relationship between God and Shakti? Can somebody tell me? What is the relationship between God and Shakti? That's a real quiet lot, huh? Koi to kuch bolo bhai, akele akele bolenge to hum bhi bol rahenge, aap bhi bol rahenge. Ishwar aur Ishwar ki Shakti mein kya relationship hai? Omnipotency. So, what is the relationship between God and Shakti? Both are Shiv, Shakti. What? Who is Shiv and who is Shakti? See, because it's very important to have our concepts clear. Jab aap physics padhte hain, don't you need your concepts clear? Otherwise, you get any marks. So, if we are studying the yogic science, our concepts must be clear, our mind must be clear. Otherwise, if there's a fog in the mind, there is no clarity in the mind, our actions are also formed. Shiva and Shakti are essentially one. But Shiva is the essence and Shakti is the executrix force of Shiva. For instance, Dr. Rajiv Thakur. He is Dr. Rajiv Thakur. But the Shakti that he manifests is the Shakti of Rajiv Thakur. Rajiv Thakur without his Shakti would not be able to manifest anything. And if Rajiv Thakur were not there, would his Shakti be there? No? So, without Shiva, without the essence, without God, Shakti would not be. Right? Without Shakti, God would not be able to manifest. How can God do his work? Only with the help of his own Shakti. We must understand these concepts. Now, Shakti has four personalities. Does anybody here know what are the four potential, four personalities of Shakti? Maha. Okay. There are four personalities of Shakti. When she manifests knowledge, then we call her Maheshwari. When she manifests fierce will and love for all that is God, we call her Mahakal. When she manifests wisdom, knowledge, we call her Maheshwari. When she manifests the fierce will and love for all that is divine, we call her Mahakali. When she manifests the supreme charm of love, joy, beauty, the bestower of prosperity, what do we call her? Mahalakshmi. Ye sabko pata hai. Isme to koi gadbad ho nahi sakti, hai na? And when she manifests perfection, organization, skills, when she has, yes, Mahasaraswati, very good. So this is Shakti. And all the powers and personalities of Shakti are present where? Within each one of us. All of us have all these four personalities, all these four potentials within us. And what we need to do is bring them out. Perfect each one of these as they come about. We all manage our life, right? Ma'am manages her classes very well. She manages her home very well. But has anybody thought about it? Who manages this universe? How? So many portfolios. No? Never you hear that bloody Jupiter to galti se apne us raaste pe chalne ki jagah Mars ke raaste mein aa gaya. Did you hear about that? Somebody must be managing it, na? Can it happen all automatically? Can it happen automatically? अरे आज तो सूर्य निकलना भूल गया. ऐसा होता है. Somebody must be managing it. So there must be many portfolios there. And in a lighter way, we can say that the education minister of the universe is Maheshwari. Defense minister is Mahakali. And the finance minister is
Mahalakshmi.
What the fuck the baap dekh nahi rahe. And the HRD minister is Mahasaraswati. So they are all managing the universe so beautifully. Now if we want to succeed in any mission, do we all have a mission in life? What's our mission in life? Kuch to socha hoga, bol do. What's our mission in life? Whatever our mission in life, right? Whatever our mission in life, if we want to succeed in it, we must be able to tap that potential that lies hidden within us. We may easily say, kya ni, ye sab se kya matlab hai, pata nahi main aaj kya bole ja rahi. Isse mere ko difficulties come as opportunities for us to grow. Now, if we are wanting to do Bhakti Yoga, it is to use the instrument of our emotions to unite with God. And then what do? Bhakti Yoga. Then we love God intensely. Intensely with all our heart we love God. And we want to love Him more and more and more. We want to love Him in the physical, we want to love Him in the subtle, we want to love Him in nature. We see Him in everybody who's talking to us, who's meeting us, who's bringing us up. Everywhere we see Him. There is no difference between the other person and me. We've all become one. That is Bhakti Yoga, because you love Him so much that you love Him in everybody, because everybody, He has become everybody. He's not only there up there in the seven skies, in the heavens. He has become this universe. That is Bhakti Yoga. And then we come to the power of acting. We must choose to become perfect servants of the Divine. Everything we are doing, we are going to study, we offer the studies to the Divine. And that becomes Karma Yoga, when our work we are offering to the Divine and joining with the Divine through our action. That becomes Karma Yoga. So we just go through it. We may consciously choose to become aware of Shakti's presence constantly, to invoke her in all that we think, all that we feel, all that we do. We can become conscious, and consciously we do that. We consciously connect with her constantly. Choice is ours. Ordinarily, some of us human beings choose to live our lives unaware of this mysterious force. Again, I repeat myself, kya matlab hai main is lecture se? Well, I need a good job. I need to finish my education, find a job, have a family, become happy. This is the aim of our lives. And then we choose to become unaware of this potential within us. We choose to become unaware that we can invoke her. We choose to become unaware that my potentiality can blend into her potentiality. And then I will become limitless in my potentiality. Right? Why are we choosing to remain unaware? Because we have limited goals. हमारा गोल बस इतना ही है कि अच्छा सा जॉब मिल जाए, अच्छा सा हस्बैंड मिल जाए, अच्छी सी वाइफ मिल जाए, सुंदर सुंदर थोड़े से बच्चे हो जाए, सुंदर सुंदर सी मेरी लाइफ चले. और हम सोचते हैं कि ये सब हम अपने छोटे से दिमाग से, छोटे से इमोशन से और थोड़ा थोड़ा एक्शन करके हमें मिल जाएगा. पर वी आर नॉट अवेयर कि जब हम अपनी अनलिमिटेड पोटेंशियल, उस शक्ति को जागृत कर देंगे, तो वो छोटा सा जॉब शायद बड़ा सा जॉब हो जाए और हमारा छोटा सा दिमाग शायद बड़ा सा दिमाग हो जाए. वी आर अनअवेयर एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी चूज टू रिमेन अनअवेयर, बिकॉज वी डोंट नो दैट एवरीथिंग विल बिकम टेनफोल्ड और 100-fold मोर इफ वी हार्नेस शक्ति एंड ब्लेंड दैट शक्ति इनटू दैट शक्ति. राइट? सो टुडे वी रिपीट आवरसेल्फ, लेट अस कॉन्शियसली चूज टू बिकम अवेयर of that presence constantly. Har samay, ek ek second mujhe uski yaad bani rahe. We invoke her in all that we do. Har samay hum class ke liye ja rahe hain, ek second ke liye yaad kiya, oh Lord, I think of you, oh Shakti, I think of you. I offer to you my going to the class. I am studying for an exam. Oh my sweet Lord, oh my sweet Shakti, I offer to you the study that I am doing. While I am writing the paper, I offer to you. अपना क्या जा रहा है? 4 सेकंड लगे बोलने में, टाइम लगा क्या बोलने में कि हे भगवान, मैं ये जो करने जा रहा था ये मैं आपको अर्पण करता हूँ. जैसा आपने बोला था सरेंडर, आपने बोला था ना, मैं सरेंडर का मतलब ये है, सरेंडर का भी और सुंदर वर्ड है ऑफर. जो कर रहे हैं हम ऑफर कर रहे हैं, झगड़ा कर रहे हैं अपने फ्रेंड से, चलो पॉजिटिव की बात क्यों करें, नेगेटिव की बात करें. अगर हम वो झगड़ा अपने माइंड से कर रहे हैं, इमोशन से कर रहे हैं, तो बहुत स्टूपिड सा झगड़ा होएगा. बट अगर हम वो झगड़ा करते समय उसको याद कर लेते हैं, शक्ति को, बोलते हैं ये शक्ति बड़ा गुस्सा आ रहा है मुझे उसके ऊपर, उसने मुझे एकदम बिट्रे कर दिया है, एंड आई ऑफर दिस झगड़ा टू यू, नाउ यू फाइट फॉर मी. कैन यू इमेजिन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फाइट दैट विल बी? इट विल बी अ फाइट विच इनसाइड इज लविंग. अंदर से वो प्यार कर रहा है अपने फ्रेंड को और बाहर से वो कुछ बोल रहा है. So this is the potentiality that we will open ourselves to if we invoke her in all that we think, all that we feel, all that we do. And let us consciously choose today to connect with her constantly. Now ma'am ka question aata hai. Kya question tha ma'am aapka? If we invoke Shakti, if we start invoking Shakti constantly, what are the changes that we will see in ourselves? Can anybody tell me what are the changes we will see in ourselves? What are the changes that you think will happen to you when you start invoking Shakti?
Balance between body, mind and action.
Very nice. There will become a kind of a balance. Because body kuch kar raha hai. Body bolta hai, abhi tumhe ko sona hai, abhi nahi uthke padhne ka man hai. Mind kar raha hai, please yaar utho padho. और इमोशन कह रहा है फ्रेंड ने बुलाया है मैकडॉनल्ड्स में, तो समझ नहीं आ रहा बॉडी कुछ कर रहा है, मेरी बॉडी बोलता है लेथार्जिक उसकी आदत है एंड द इमोशन इज सेइंग नो नो लेट्स गो एंड हैव अ पिज्जा और समथिंग, माइंड इज सेइंग वी मस्ट स्टडी. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कंटोर्शन डिस्टॉर्शन बिटवीन द थ्री विल गेट सॉल्व. व्हाट एल्स विल हैपन टू अस वंस वी स्टार्ट इनवोकिंग शक्ति? यू फील एम्पावर्ड. वेरी गुड. What else will happen to us when we invoke Shakti? Abhi, what is happening to us? We are all Bahirmukhi. You know what is Bahirmukhi? All of us are looking outward. अरे यार उसकी गलती है, वो जो है ना उसने मुझे पढ़ने नहीं दिया, मैकडॉनल्ड्स में बुला लिया, मेरी कोई गलती थोड़ी है, उसकी गलती है, उसने रात को मेरे को लेट कर रखा इसलिए आई डिडंट गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग. सी, बट वंस यू स्टार्ट इनवोकिंग Shakti, you will become antarmukhi. And everywhere you will be able to see your own faults. And when you see your faults, you will pick them up and you will place them before Shakti. Oh Shakti, I am lethargic. Please help me Shakti, please help me. Oh Shakti, I have so much anger in my being. I responded to her so badly, I would have kept quiet. And I wouldn't have had to go and apologize. But it is only when we will start invoking Shakti that we will start looking at our faults pitilessly. Right now we look at other people's faults pitilessly. But then we will start looking at our own faults pitilessly. And then we will feel pressed that ye main kam apni kami ko dur kar hi nahi pa rahi. Now what should I do? And then we remember, oh Shakti is there. I can just offer my faults to Shakti and she will help me to root them out. The more sincere our prayer to Shakti, the more sincere will be her response to us. Our own negativities, obstacles, limitations, desires, our monster-like ego. You know our ego monster? It's a huge monster sitting within us. Are men, this is realize all of us have it? That men is so huge, it's like a monster inside us. All these will become very painful for us to see. When we look at that man, oh my God, what a shame. I said something so egoistic. That will happen to us when we invoke Shakti. Our whole being will aspire to change and change integrally. Every part of our being will start saying, oh, I need to remove this. I need to remove this coming from me. I need to remove this desire from me. When we talk of removing desire, does it mean we should have no desires? If we don't have any desires, will we be able to have any motivation to work?
No.
So how do we handle desire then? Because they say that the two main problems of life, should we wait for the light to come or? Come on, I need some answers for the. From the audience, the two main problems of our life are, I just mentioned that, yes,
desire and ego.
Exactly. So how are we, how should we handle them? Come on from the students. Yes, you. Yes, don't look around. How do we handle desire and ego? What do you suggest? Should we stop desiring? Then what do we do with desire? Desire to get, I need a good job, I need to get good marks, yes?
Work hard to achieve
work hard to achieve it. Is there something else that we can do to the desire?
मैं हमारी डेंसिटी की तरह हमें उसके अकॉर्डिंग ही वर्क करना चाहिए विद नो सी बियॉन्ड द
हमारी क्या क्या मेरे अंदर फोर्स है What you meant to say was, however much force I had, I should be able to put all of that in the work. And you said, please answer so everybody knows what should we do with our desire?
Work hard to achieve it.
Work hard to achieve it. But is there anything else that we need to do to desire? Because some people say that remove desire only. Can we remove desire?
No, it's not possible.
So what do we need to remove? What is it in desire that needs to be removed? There is some part of desire which needs to be removed. Obsession. Very good. Who said that? Very good. What's your name?
Sandhya.
Sandhya. Very good answer. Very, very good answer. Obsession with the desire needs to be removed. What else needs to be removed?
We have to put our desires in a perspective so that we can do it in a positive
way. Beg your pardon?
We have to put our desires in a perspective.
What kind of perspective?
In a positive sense.
What is the positive sense?
We can offer our desires to God.
Offer our desires to God, that's the first step. Very good. Second?
So that all our actions and energies are analyzed in a positive direction.
Very good. Very good. And what is the positive direction? Gita has given two very simple rules for action. One, you know it, yes?
Karma.
How is the karma to be done? Again from the Gita? Very good. Nishkam karma ka kya matlab hota hai? Yes, I have pegged. I want to get this. Now this is the result I'm looking at. But now after I've seen the result and I've decided that to get there, I have to walk on this path. Now when I'm walking on this path, should I keep looking at the goal? No, you have already taken the path. So Gita has given two very beautiful things about karma. कैसे कर करना है? फर्स्ट सबसे जरूरी जो आपने बोला आपका नाम क्या है प्रांजल वेरी नाइस आंसर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफर योर डिजायर टू द डिवाइन शक्ति देन योग कर्म सु कौशलम विल यू रिपीट इट आफ्टर मी योग कर्म सु कौशलम व्हाट डज इट मीन हू कैन टेल मी जो भी कर्म कर रहे हो उसे पूर्ण कुशलता के साथ करो Which minister do we get here? Maha Saraswati. She does every work with absolute perfection. It is full, complete perfection. So Gita tells us, हमारे को desire है. Accept that you have the desire. Set your goal for achieving that desire. But first of all, make a yoga out of your karma. And how do we make a yoga out of the karma? What Pranjal told us? Offer it to the divine. After offering it to the divine, start charting out your method. When you chart out your method, do the work with absolute, as much perfection and kushalta as you can do. Yoga karma su kaushalam. Another thing that Krishna tells us in the Gita is, samatvam yoga uchyate. While you're doing the karma, there has to be complete equilibrium and poise and grace in your being. वो करते समय थोड़े से अच्छे मार्क्स आ गए और जी वो ये वो बैंड बाजा बज गया उसका नो सो व्हाट ऑफर इट दैट लिटिल रिजल्ट दैट हैज कम ऑन द वे व्हाट डू वी डू विद द रिजल्ट अगेन प्लेस इट एट द फीट ऑफ गॉड किसने दिया है वो रिजल्ट हमने मेहनत करी बट रिजल्ट तो उनका है वी हैव नो राइट ऑन द रिजल्ट ऑफर इट एंड देन अगेन मूव फॉरवर्ड इफ आई कीप लुकिंग देयर We may trip on the way. Let's look at the next step, but let's do it with kushalta and let's do it with equanimity in our being. And then our actions will become more and more beautiful. So when we start invoking Shakti, we start looking at our limitations more and more. And then we start plucking them out. Sri Aurobindo has said, pluck out desire from its bleeding roots. When we pluck out the desire, it bleeds. But it's okay because we are not plucking out the desire per se. We are plucking out what that lady, the girl from the back had said, the obsession with the desire, the obsession with the food. Let's pluck it out. It may bleed, but it doesn't matter. and then go ahead with your work. Then someday will come that we will start experiencing the force of Shakti working through us, undisturbed by our desires and ego. We will not feel that desire and ego anymore because Shakti has started working through us undisturbed. And when Shakti flows through us uninterrupted, then we may become that bow through which Krishna is sending out the arrows of his action, the arrows of his thought, the arrows of his emotions. His actions will flow through us. His emotions will flow through us. And his thoughts will flow through us. But for us to reach that point where Shakti flows uninterrupted through our beings, first of all our surrender should be complete. Our aspiration to reach Shakti should be complete. And we have to be constantly vigilant of ourselves. Constantly we should be able to look at ourselves with a magnifying glass. Not look at others with a magnifying glass. Look at ourselves and transform our beings. These are the conditions we need to fulfill if we aspire to invoke Shakti. The last question, do we have time? Oh, time is over, we can leave the last question. There is, sure. How do we acknowledge and honor Shakti? How do we acknowledge Shakti? How do we honor Shakti? Does anybody have an answer? When we are in the presence of all that is wonderful, what is Shakti? She's wonderful. She's all loving. She's mysterious. She's beautiful. Now, when you are in such a presence, there is only one sentiment that will arise out of us, and that is of utter adoration. You will adore her. If you are in such a presence, what else will happen to you? So, let us adore her. Where do we adore her? How do we adore her? First of all, we adore her in the individual, inside ourselves. We know Shakti is inside me. So let us adore her inside me. Then let us adore her in the cosmos. When you look at a leaf on the tree, or the fruit on the tree, or the flower, or the butterfly, or the grass, or the person next door, or the person who is asking for some alms from you on the road, it is all her. She is working inside that person who is asking you for some help. She is that person inside that person who is fighting with you. Let us adore her in the universal, everywhere. And then let us adore her as a transcendental. Do you know what transcendental means? What does transcendental mean? The divine God is within us. The divine God is in the cosmos. And the divine God is beyond the cosmos. He is beyond the solar system. He is beyond it all. So we have to adore her in all these spaces. She is everywhere. And let us be. Now let us understand one thing. Even the Supreme Lord is in adoration of his Shakti. Even Shiva, has anybody watched Mahadev? Do you see how much he adores Parvati? So that may seem like a mythology, but the actual fact is that God adores Shakti. It is his own energy. And it is so beautiful that he cannot help but adore her. Right? Now I want to share a big secret about Shakti with you. So I'm going to, don't look at, now let me tell you about the secret. We said Shakti is within us, right? Where is Shakti within us? Tell me, can anybody tell me where is Shakti within us? Yes, so when we said she is within us, she is fully, potentially, completely there. But now the secret that I am going to tell you is, how many cells do we have in our body? Trillion, zillion, million, I don't know the numbers, right? Each one of the cells, the nucleus of each one of these cells, Shakti is sitting. She is sitting in the nucleus of each one of these cells. Now what happens in an atom bomb? How does an atom bomb give so much, such a big explosion? there is energy inside the atom, and atom and energy from outside is fused inside this atom, and what happens? Huge explosion takes place of energy, right? Now when we come to know that energy is hidden within each and every nucleus of each and every cell of my body, right? And then we are invoking Shakti from up there, and we are inviting her to come and fuse inside each and every atom of our body. What will happen? This Shakti will get fused with this Shakti, and there will be a huge, huge manifestation of Shakti from within you. Right? This is a huge secret that hardly anybody ever speaks about, but Sri Aurobindo has told us about it. The mother has told us about it. So let us allow that Shakti to penetrate the cells of our body when we meditate. Let us allow that Shakti to awaken within us and penetrate each and every cell of our body. Right? And I would like to end this talk with a few lines from the poem, epic poem Savitri, written by Sri Aurobindo on the hidden powers of Shakti within the nature cells. Please listen to this with concentration. I don't know why it's disappeared. A greater destiny waits you in your front. Authors of Earth's high change, to you it is given to cross the dangerous spaces of the soul and touch the mighty mother stark awake and meet the omnipotent in this house of flesh and make of life the million bodied one. Thank you.
Got some insight about the Shakti and the role of Shakti in our life. So now I request BG Singh sir to share his views and something about the session.
It is spiritually about which I have no idea, but about Shiva and all that. Our mundane thinking about Shiva is that yes, he is omnipotent and universal, and he is the embodiment of ultimate Shakti. That we understand. It was a really good exposition that she has given. It's coming from her heart. That is the quintessence of the philosophy that or Vedanta or Gita talks about. Actually, I sometimes yatra yogeshwaro Krishna yatra parko dharunga. Where there is the transformational leader, as I call it, in the shape of Lord Krishna, that comes as enlightened leader in the shape of the Krishna, and where there is action in shape of Arjuna. Arjuna was simply action. He was an instrument, as she was telling. The fruit will be coming. There will be wings in the mantle of life. And that is the ultimate thing that Gita talks about in the last sloka of Gita. Actually, I am not at all prepared. I am so much engrossed in listening to her that I have never structured my thinking. Maybe one day, I think even 1 hour, but I am talking about something about moral compass that one has to develop. A moral compass in our life. That will be simply practical kind of things that I will be talking. But not now, because I am now not at all ready. I talk about Krishna, I talk about Shiva, all in context of management and management. And then I have said many wrong things that I thought, but I drive home to these students, and especially older students like maybe general managers and all that, that goes straight into their mind and heart, because basically all of us are. Ellen is just in a sense, Indians are very good. This is the talk that you get through your methodology, giving the example and all that. That becomes very, very easy to be understood. So I'm really sorry, friend. Otherwise, also I cannot imagine the talk that Madam has given. It's a really wonderful talk that she has given, and really I'm grateful that she has come and you have invited me. It's very, very good. Thank you very much. Thank you.
While the man was speaking, I was thinking of that beautiful couplet of Iqbal, who says, when everything starts from self and ends at self, dhoondta rehta hu Iqbal apne aap ko main, dhoondta rehta hu Iqbal apne aap ko main, magar goya musafir bhi main hu aur manzil bhi main hu apne aap mein. So I would sum it up in my own humble fashion. I would say that when a person becomes a silent witness to his or her own thoughts, emotions and actions, probably the generation of Shakti automatically takes place. And as Nan was saying, that when you get awakened to the presence of Shakti, when you invoke her and when you get connected up with her, then you become Gyan Yogi, you become Dharma Yogi, and you become Karma Yogi. And then again, the poet has beautifully said, kya bataun, kya kya nazar aata hai, zarre zarre mein tera jalwa nazar aata hai, khili jo kaliyan, mili teri muskaan. Now muskaan is here symbolizing the positivity. Khili jo kaliyan, mili teri muskaan, gulon mein tera muskurana nazar aata hai. Thank you very much.
Thank you first to the students who listened so quietly, intently. Thank you so much. You were a really wonderful audience. And bahut acha laga aap log ke saath interact karke. Thank you so much for inviting me.